pray.
Wallahi, this goes back to the court, man. It goes back to the ulama. Because some ulama say yes, some ulama say no. You know, some could say he's still a Muslim. But some scholars like Al-Uthaymeen, Ibn Baz, may Allah have mercy upon them, Fawzan, they say the man doesn't pray as a kafir, so they should seek divorce. But not all of them, so I say they still advise him. You know, but it's a bad example to have a man doesn't pray at home. Like the children, that's what I'm saying.
Pray. Can a man leave his wife, she don't pray?
Huh? The same thing some ulama mentioned. But they will say, advise him first, tell him to pray, or she prays. You know, like I said, it's a calamity, you Muslims don't pray. It's a calamity, it is a calamity. It's a joke, akhi. Muslims don't pray, doesn't make any sense. Muslim la yusalli hadi ma fi hadi. Shay ajib, you know? That's a joke. And sometimes, akhi, some people giving da'wah, or try to give da'wah to non-Muslims, himself doesn't pray. Bro, yourself, there's a shak about you if you're Muslim or kafir. You know, that's why this speaker's corner is allowing anyone to give da'wah. And I advise my brothers, before you record anyone, you have to do investigation about him, man. Don't record anyone because he's giving da'wah to a Christian. Wallahi, I've heard people say some kufri statement and he gives da'wah.
Exactly.
Shirky statements.
When them start mentioning kufr now, then you start speaking against them, them say use this and use that.
No, I'm just giving,
trying to correct them.
That's Alhamdulillah, I'm doing the sunnah way, making it general. Na'am, ma balu aqwamin. Why people? I've noticed that. The people, subhanAllah, give da'wah, akhi. There's a guy who used to give da'wah, he doesn't come anymore. Time for prayer, you can't see him. He just, akhi, you know, you combine all the prayers in one time, ulaysh. You know, subhanAllah. So that's why da'wah is very important. Da'wah is the way of the prophets and messengers. Not this da'wah that we see. You study science and you come give da'wah. That's not the da'wah, barakallahu fik. The da'wah is, قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدْعُو إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَى بَصِيرَةٍ أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي. That is my path, you know, to call to Allah. According to what is the basira here, as the ulama explained, with knowledge. I'm not saying you have to be a scholar, you know, but with knowledge. And knowledge, Quran and Sunnah. That's the knowledge, you know, barakallahu fikum. You know, I'm not saying you have to be perfect. All of us, we have our shortcomings. You know, we have our own struggles. But, you know, to give da'wah and your jahil in the abjadiyat al-Islam, in the basics of Islam you jahil about, and you go give da'wah. But because what's happening now, giving da'wah become entertainment. Yeah, akhi. TikTok, full of them. Bible said, John, Mark, Luke, Matthew. And this guy's famous on TikTok. Next minute, brother, what's this John, Paul, Mark? Akhi, what's this? You ask aqidah, don't you aqidah. Subhanallah, Sheikh Fawzan, hafidah Allah Ta'ala. He said, before you give a da'wah, you have to study your aqidah first. That's what we have to do. You know, you have to study our aqidah first. What is the correct belief of the Muslim? You give da'wah, then ask the person, where is Allah? Allah is everywhere. Brother, you need da'wah first. Allah is above his creation, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the way befits his majesty. You know, you have no clue about Allah's names and attributes. You know, barakallahu fikum. So it's very important, my brothers. We have to know who do we take our knowledge from. You know, subhanallah, or the prayer. Like I see some people making wudu, or the way they pray. You know, subhanallah. So we have to learn. I was jahil and I'm still jahil, but all of us, we have to learn, especially the basics, you know, the salat. Salat is very important. And get the book by Imam Al-Albani, may Allah have mercy upon him, Sifatu Salat al-Nabi. There's two. There's one by Shubh Uthaymeen. There's one by Imam Muqbin Hadi al-Wadi'i, Imam Ibn Uthaymeen, Imam Al-Albani. How to pray. Buy them and see how, you know. Like, you know, subhanAllah, some people just, I see people pray like this, say, Allah Akbar. Brother, you're not praying, you know, just, you just do movement. Yeah. Yeah, and there's a hadith about the hadith Abu Huraira. The hadith Abu Huraira. The Nabi Abu Huraira Anas. From the signs of the hour, people will be praying like a chicken picking the food.
Yeah,
they're packing the food like this quick. You know? Where's Tuma'nina? And the Tuma'nina from the arkan of a salat. You know, take your time, you know. You know, imagine you go to see someone that you love so much. You don't go sit to him, salam alaikum, bye bye, take care. And you go away. No, you're gonna take your time. Speak to him. What about the one that we love more than anything else? Rather, our love is based upon his, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. You know, I'm not saying always have to be perfect in your prayer. Sometimes the shaitan play with our minds, no doubt. But akhi, you know, taking your time in the ruku', in the sujood, you know, alhamdulillah, akhi, yasi, subhanAllah, even just people's focus, Bible, Christianity, Bible. It's not a da'wah, barakallahu fikum. Yeah, for Quran, Sunnah. And also watching debate too much is not good for our hearts. You see some people are just debate. It's not good for the heart, you know. Barakallahu feekum. Is give a reminder, you know. Learn Quran, read the Quran, study the Quran, alhamdulillah. Read the books of Imam al-Salaf. May Allah have mercy upon them. But you know, subhanAllah, just a Christian, and you know, just subhanAllah, some calamities you see in the park, you know, subhanAllah. And it's the mushkila of social media. Some people, they want to become famous.
So we understand this hadith. I mean, you know, different people speak about that hadith.
Yeah.
And I heard a brother say, I'm not sure about that.
Huh?
Brothers, oh, I don't want to hear him.
So yeah, khalas.
No, read it anyway.
Yeah, the hadith of...
I don't understand. How do you deal with it?
The hadith, I'll address it. But I was going to mention, now some people, they already have that desire to become famous. Some brothers are recording them. You're giving them what they want. They come in, ya akhi. New brother, who are you? Okay, oh, no one knows him. Ah, because he said the Bible, John, Mark, Luke, Matthew. ما هكذا تورد أوردها سعد وما هكذا تورد الإبل يا سعد وما هكذا تورد الإبل يا سعد. You know, this is saying there was a man who tried to feed the camels, but he didn't know how to do it. So his brother told him off. You know, his brother told him off. As for the hadith of Abu Huraira, I think the narrator of Sahih Muslim, لا يؤمن بأحد أو لا يسمع بأحد من هذه أمة يهوديا أو نصرانيا ولا يؤمن بما جئت به إلا أو بما أرسلت به إلا كان من أصحاب النار أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام that anyone from this ummah, because there's two tough ummah. There's ummah al-da'wa and ummah al-ijaba. Ummah al-da'wa, the Jews and the Christians and other than them. Ummah al-ijaba, the Muslimun. And Nabi عليه الصلاة والسلام said any Jew or a Christian that hears what I came with, does not believe in it, except he will be from the people of Jahannam. What does it mean? He does not hears of it, as Imam Al-Bani explained to ulama, mean he understand the message. Because if a Rafidi comes to a Christian and tell about Islam and he rejects it, the Hijjah has not been established upon the Kafir. Because why? The Rafidi Islam is not Islam. It's Islam of the Mushrikun. Okay? Or Qadianis. You understand? Likewise, understand? So Islam, and this is the beauty of the Muslims, you see, we stand and explain our religion to Islam. In the cell, alhamdulillah, because we have nothing to be ashamed of, alhamdulillah. So they give da'wah to people, alhamdulillah, and we have to learn. Be busy with Quran. Quran, ikhwan, listen to Quran. You cannot read, listen to the Quran, alhamdulillah. The Quran took billions of people out of darkness into the light, alhamdulillah. This is a noble book. A brother became Muslim a week ago from Poland. Jamal was with me. And he said, I said, how you become Muslim? He was wearing a suit. I said, how you become Muslim? He said, I'm going through hardship. And my worker is a Sudanese. So he gave me a Quran and he said, read it. He said, every time I'm feeling down, I read the Quran. I start feeling better. And I said, this book, I have to study more about this book. He studied more about Islam, Prophet Muhammad, he became a Muslim. Subhanallah. So likewise, no, block him. Also, subhanallah, there is the insane donkey.
I don't want him in my ears, brother.
I'm a different
man. I don't want him. You spoke about gospel. Baba, just ignore him. Baba, he. When I want to
shout, not my ears. What I was gonna say? You know, to tell this story. I don't speak about the gospel. I'm the Quran. I'm a Muslim. I'm not Christian. You go speak about the gospel.
Why did you mention it?
This حمار من جهة حمار. كيف أنا أتكلم عن الغسبول؟ أتكلم عن القرآن يا أخي. أنا مسلم.
Three, four times you mentioned gospel.
Did you mention the gospel? Did you mention gospel?
No.
I mentioned about the Muslims using it. I said the Muslims stop using it because that Bible is not in need of it. That Bible, the Christian country have put it in the bin. But your Indian is still following it.
So you are
Wallahi, ya akhi. Okay, my dog, I'm going to walk away. Let him come. Let's akhwa. My Muslim brothers, let's. My dog, come. Mama, come. Come. No brothers, you know you come, akhwa. My dog, mama. Come. All of you, children, ladies. Come. Come, follow us. Here, I have water for you, water. Hada wallahi, akhwa. Some brothers, they think, I'm dealing with him harsh. He deserves it. This man is Adu al-Rahman. He is enemy of Allah and his messenger. That's how you deal with him. We respect all people regardless, Christian, Jewish, atheist, we respect them. However, this man, he every Sunday, he comes, just disturb the brothers and lies against Allah and his messenger. So we have no respect for him. And this da'wah of al-Inbitahiyin, some Muslim wants us to do, da'wah of watering down Islam, I'm not in need of it. Because yes, To be soft is good, but also to be harsh sometimes is good too. نعم. الله سبحانه وتعالى مجد عند القرآن. ولا تجادلوا أهل الكتاب إلا بالتي أحسن إلا الذين ظلموا منهم. Many brothers ينسوا هذه الآية إلا الذين ظلموا منهم. حاكم غير الآية الأولى أو جاء نصف الآية. Allah said call and debate and have a discussion with the people of the book with, in a good way except those who have transgressed. الإمام عبد الرحمن بن ناصر السعدي may Allah have mercy upon Ibn Taymiyyah mentioned mean if they transgress you have to be tough with them and strong with them. That's from the Islamic teaching. Islam doesn't if someone slap you don't give him the other cheek. Fight back. Understand? Alhamdulillah, yeah. Wallahi akhi. So Alhamdulillah, look, we talk about Islam. I'm saying the Muslim should not be every single or every Sunday John Luke Mark. No, Alhamdulillah, Quran. Alhamdulillah, many people, subhanAllah, talking about suffering and so what, stress and all of that. Read the Quran and understand it. Let us read the Quran and listen to the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove that depression, inshallah ta'ala, from you. You understand, inshallah ta'ala. The Quran, Allah said, Inna hadha al-Quran yahdi lillati hiya aqwam. That this Quran guides that which is best. Al-Imam Muhammad Amin al-Shinqit, may Allah have mercy upon him, from the scholars of Mauritania. Mauritania is a beautiful country, mashallah, Mauritania. Al-Ilm, you know, there's a lot of scholars from Mauritania came. He mentioned in his tafsir, he said, Aqwam in ibadat, wal-mu'amalat, wal-akhlaq, in everything. It guides you that which is best in transaction, in worship, in dealings, in everything, and the most important one, which is the tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's different between Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah and Ahl al-Bid'ah wal-Ahwa'. Ahl al-Sunnah, they don't focus only on be good to your friends. No, be good to Allah first. If you look at the other guys, some Muslims, look, akhi, you have bad manners, but he's mubtadi' dal, misguided person. Where is your manners with Allah and his messenger? No, don't talk about him, brother. I'm speaking there, not speaking. I'm going to go like this. But I'll ask you, where is the manners with Allah and his messenger by following it, singing out Allah in worship and following the sunnah? But because you care about human beings more than Allah. SubhanAllah. Ikhwa, don't entertain this donkey, wallahi. I have no respect for him. Yeah, don't respect for him, Barakallah.
The boy, Bob, try say, well, I don't know if he becomes him when I turn, but him try if he's some of that weak fit, so he's coming. He said, boy, I'm going to talk to liars, I move, and he kind of switch from
yeah, forget that. This guy just
I don't talk to them. And you got Muslims, they're giving them air time.
Akhi, there's him, that guy, Chris, this is Shaitan. What is it? Yeah, look, some Muslims speaking to him sometimes. There's no need to speak to him. There's no need. What we need, akhwa, if you have enough knowledge to give da'wah about something, speak to someone who's sincere. If it's not, you know, be at home, read the Quran, read the Sunnah, you know. Inshallah ta'ala. It's a reminder to me first, may Allah bless you all. And if you have any question or correction, you are more than welcome. If you have something, you know, we make mistakes. All of us, we make mistakes. We are Bani Adam. If you have any correction or any question, then tafaddalu, barakallahu fikum.
Yeah, man asked me about his he said he had only missed days for Ramadan, yeah. And he said he needed to does he have to clear them up before the next Ramadan? So I told him, yeah.
Yeah, that's what the scholar said, yeah. He said except if you have a valid reason to not do it, but you have to do it before Ramadan. And some scholars said if you have no valid reason to not make it up before Ramadan, and you have to do it after the Ramadan, the next Ramadan, then you have to make up the days. Also, you give what? You feed the person.
Along with the days?
Yeah, the days.
Along with the days?
Yeah.
That's if you don't make up the days before.
Before, without any valid reason. Yeah. So you have to make it up, what do you call it? But some scholars said, no, it's enough to make up the days of Ramadan. Yeah. Let me ask you a question. What is the blessed water?
Zamzam.
Water, bismillah.
Who agrees with him?
Bismillah.
No, there's a blessed water we have there, huh?
Well, Zamzam.
Zamzam is, everyone thinks it is.
Is it all the time? Zamzam is the blessed water?
any water you read Quran.
No, no, Zamzam has special. Zamzam is blessed.
Any water when you read Quran, it's
blessed. Yeah, yeah, but Zamzam, if you read Quran, you become more blessed. Yeah, yeah. Yeah. No, they say, the scholars mention, the mu'jiza of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, the water coming out from his fingers. That that water, it was more blessed.
We ain't gonna
get yeah. That, huh? No, the more, no, the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam more honor.
How do you know that?
Because Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, he's a the best miracle was given to him.
Best miracle.
Yeah.
What about Moses? He's got different miracles as well.
Yeah, but I'm saying now.
Jesus got even better miracles.
Jesus.
Yeah.
So the Quran.
Huh? He was raising the dead.
So what about the Quran? No, no.